Putting a clickable link in your LibriVox signature. My goodness, that's hard to say. Hello, this is Phil Chenevert with a little tidbit on adding a clickable link in your signature for LibriVox forum. If you're tired of having a signature that's just bland and blah, this is how you're going to do it. Right here on the page that you're looking at is Barry. He's one of our famous administrators. His signature is underneath this line, and it's where yours will be too. And he's got his name, and then he's got a link directly to his LibriVox page. This link can be to any web address that we choose. However, most of us, or a lot of us, link it to our own personal LibriVox project page. So first, let's see how to add a clickable web address of any kind. And then we'll walk through later on adding your project page link. First, you need to have a web address. Now I'm going to take this one, which is the web address of our LibriVox forums, copy it. Then you can go to any forum page, find your user control panel, click once. This is my user control panel. I'm going to go to profile. I hope you can see all this. Move that over. Profile. Edit signature. Okay, now I'm at my signature block, you could call it, where I can type in what I want. Currently, all I have is my poor little old name. However, I'm going to right-click and paste that web address that we just copied. Now, at the bottom of your signature page here, am I having troubles? Yes, I am. There's way at the bottom, there's something called preview, so you can see what it will look like. I'm going to click on that and say this is what it'll look like. My name and then a link, but that is not clickable, is it? No, it is not. Well, let's go back up here and I'll show you how to make anything, any web address clickable. Highlight it, click URL, and it turns it immediately and instantly into a clickable link. Let's go back and look at it, preview. There it is, folks. If I were to click on that, it would take me directly to the LibriVox forum page. So you can make any web address into a clickable web address inside of your signature, or you can put these same type of things inside all of your posts if you want to, because you can use that anywhere. That's a free piece of advice, by the way. With one important note that you need to understand, in your edit signature box, there is something called Disable BB code that stands for bulletin board code. And this box must be unchecked, blank, empty, void, vacant, whatever you want to call it. Because if you put a check in there, you will not be able to make any links at all. And that is, for some reason, these usually come by default as checked. So just eliminate that right away. Just uncheck it. Now this is a utilitarian web address, meaning it can work and it will work, but it's not very pretty. I can hear you saying, well, gee, Phil, look at these here, you know, look at this one. That's a pretty one. I want mine to be that way too, or maybe not. So I'm going to show you how to do that thing. I'm going to click right here and paste the same website, which is our forum. All right. I want you to notice carefully that the web page is the same, forum.librivox.org. But this one doesn't show the actual link. It just has this fun stuff I typed down here. So to get from here to here, I would first delete the bracket, insert an equal sign, come to the end right before the open bracket, and close it. Now, my cursor is in between those two little brackets. This is where you would type your message. This is my message. Now, let's see if I did it right. We're going to preview. And now I have, this is my message. Once again, you delete the bracket here, insert an equal sign, put a bracket right in front of your, in front of your the last URL. Type in whatever you want. And that's the way it works. The last part here is to show you how to show a link to your personal LibriVox page in your signature. Well, first, you have to get the web page or the URL. Let's see if I have one up here. Yes, I do. You do this by going to any magic window like this, which has your name here. Look at that. There's my name again. You would right-click, choose Copy Link Location. Let's go back to here, right here. Okay. I'm going to paste, right-click, paste it in. Do the same thing I did before. Highlight it, URL. There you go. Now, if you remember, let's preview it and see what it looks like. It looks like this, a link. Doesn't tell me much about what that is. So we're going to change it to look like that. I'm going to delete the brackets, insert an equal sign, come to right before this bracket for the URL, put a close bracket, and since my cursor is in between those two, I can put my LibriVox page. Well, what hard is it? Let's see what it looks like. There you go. And that will take anybody that wants to see your LibriVox page right there. Thank you for watching. This is Phil Chenevert. And if you have any comments or suggestions, well, send me a personal message. I'm somewhat available. Thank you. And I expect to see some wonderful signatures out there. We didn't get to the color, but it can be colored too. I'll talk about that later.